Maria, and today we are talking about what you need to know about incognito mode. Incognito mode, privacy mode, private browsing, no matter what you or your browser calls it, using incognito mode keeps your browsing habits private. But just how private is private browsing? In this video, we will dive into the details of incognito mode, including guides for setting it up, choosing alternatives, and seeing just how private your data really is. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what exactly is incognito mode? Incognito mode is a browser setting that doesn't keep track of your history, cookies, site data, or logins while browsing. That may seem like a great way to hide your browsing habits, and it is, but only to an extent. While your browser won't keep track of certain data, your browsing activity can still be seen by websites, some search engines, and your internet service provider. As a result, private browsing often isn't quite as private as many of us would hope. While the exact functions of incognito mode may vary between different browsers, most do the following things to keep your browsing private. Doesn't keep history. Doesn't store cookies. Doesn't store site data. Doesn't save form information. Doesn't keep you logged in. Deactivates browser extensions. One of the biggest misconceptions about incognito mode is that it's completely private, which it definitely isn't. Though your browser won't save your history or data while in incognito mode, that doesn't mean the sites and search engines you visit won't either. If anything, third parties make little distinction between browsing modes. From their perspective, it's all the same. As a result, there are many things that incognito mode doesn't do, especially when it comes to your privacy and identity. Here are some of the most important things to keep in mind. Doesn't hide your IP address. Won't stop network admins from seeing your activity. Doesn't prevent your account activity from being tracked. Still visible to sites, search engines, and ISPs. Doesn't stop malware. In short, incognito mode won't hide your browsing data from third parties. Always assume that your data is fully visible, regardless of whether you're in incognito mode or not. Thankfully, several alternatives exist that do a far better job of keeping you private. As you might imagine, or already know from experience, there are plenty of reasons to use incognito mode. For most people, the biggest reason is usually to hide their browsing history from other users on the same device. While the exact reasons for wanting to do this can definitely vary, incognito mode is an extremely effective option. Of course, being discreet isn't the only reason to use incognito mode. Here are some of the most popular. Hiding your history. No matter what you're doing online, the thought of someone else seeing your browsing history is pretty uncomfortable, especially for users on shared or public devices. As a result, many people use incognito mode to simply hide their history from other users, or even themselves. Avoiding unwanted cookies. Most websites use cookies to do things like save your active logins, maintain shopping cart contents, and track your whereabouts online. As you might imagine, there are many reasons you might not want these. Avoiding some types of tracking. With no cookies or logins saved, you can avoid most forms of tracking while using incognito mode. As a result, you won't get the same targeted ads or suggestions you would normally. However, this only works as long as you don't log into any of your accounts. Staying organized. If you're using a certain browsing experience, then you know that checking out new sites or products can easily throw things off. With incognito mode, you can browse freely without having to worry about weird ads or product suggestions down the line. Browsing without extensions. While browser extensions are often very useful, they can also make our browsing experience a lot more cumbersome than it needs to be. Since incognito mode deactivates extensions in most browsers, it's useful whenever you want a clean browsing experience. Web development. Site performance is a crucial consideration for web developers. However, it's hard to measure when site data, like images and HTML files, have already been stored from previous visits. As a result, many developers use incognito mode to test performance and loading times by forcing the browser to recache site data. Most browsers make it very easy to switch into incognito mode. For a quick reference, here's how to use incognito mode on the world's most popular browsers. First, open Google Chrome and click the menu button or the vertical dots on the top right and select a new incognito window. Then switch to the new window and verify that you're in incognito mode. Open Mozilla Firefox, then click the menu button, stacked horizontal lines, on the top right and select New Private Window. Switch to the new window and verify that you're in incognito mode. First, open Microsoft Edge, then click the menu button, horizontal dots, on the top right and select New in Private Window. Switch to the new window and verify that you're in incognito mode. First, open Safari, then click File on the top left toolbar and select New Private Window. Switch to the new window and verify that you're in incognito mode. Though most popular browsers have a mobile app, many mobile users stick to the default browser on the mobile device's operating system. These are Chrome for Android and Safari for iOS. First, open the Google Chrome mobile app and then tap the menu button, vertical dots, on the top right and select New Incognito tab. Switch to the new tab and verify that you're in incognito mode. Like the desktop version, the default window should say, "You've gone incognito." Open the Safari mobile app, then tap the menu button, two overlapping squares, on the bottom right. Tap the One tab or X tabs button at the bottom. Select Private from the tab group settings. Finally, tap the Add option in the bottom left corner to open a new private tab. You can tell you're in incognito mode when the browser theme turns dark. Other browsers, such as Opera and Brave, also offer private browsing features. As you may have noticed, however, the procedure for going incognito mode is somewhat the same regardless of browser. Simply open the main menu and select the option. For alternative options and other private browsing features, be sure to consult your browser's user manual or troubleshooting guide. Depending on your private browsing needs, there are several excellent alternatives to incognito mode. Alternatives like VPNs and the Tor browser offer even greater privacy and security than incognito mode. A proxy server provides an intermediary between your device and the website you visit. By routing your traffic through a proxy, third parties won't know it's you browsing. Here in this screenshot, sender Alice wants to ask Bob what time it is without Bob knowing it's her. To do so, she sends her request through a proxy, which asks Bob on her behalf. From Bob's perspective, the proxy is the one who's asking for the time, not Alice. He sends his response to the proxy, which then sends it back to Alice. Though a proxy is an effective way of disguising yourself, it does little to secure your connection. As a result, many people use VPNs to perform the same function as a proxy, but with an extra layer of security. Though they share the same underlying principles, VPNs differ from proxies in several key ways. The biggest difference is connection security. Where proxies do little to secure your connection, VPNs encrypt your data and provide a secure connection. In doing so, only you and the VPN can see the data you send, making it so that not even your ISP knows what you're up to. Of course, just like a proxy, third parties will see the proxy server's IP address instead of yours. Another difference, however, is cost. Where many proxies are inexpensive, if not free, a top quality VPN typically costs between $5 and $12 per month. Short for the Onion Router, Tor hides your identity by encrypting your data and sending it through a random network of relays. Like a VPN or proxy, third parties won't know it's you browsing. However, unlike these tools, the Tor browser uses a random route of multiple relays each time. By not relying on a single set connection, Tor presents a far more secure option for staying private online. You can access Tor by using the free Tor browser. If you want to block cookies and other forms of tracking without the bare bones experience of incognito mode, look no further than anti-tracking software. At a minimum, anti-tracking software prevents your browser from storing tracking cookies, thereby preventing cross-site tracking. Note that most of the alternatives we've discussed, such as VPNs or Tor, already include some type of anti-tracking capability. However, if you don't need any extra security or privacy, plenty of standalone anti-tracking extensions are available. An unsecured website puts your customers and reputation at risk. With Kinsta's Cloudflare integration, all the security features you need are built right into your plan at no additional cost. That's a monthly savings of around $200 per site. Learn more about these benefits, including DDoS protection, a more secure firewall, and more at kinsta.com/cloudflare-integration. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.